So let's consider this energy balance example. Here we're going to have a semi-transparent plate, and we have convection and radiation heat transfer to and or from this plate. And using these values that are given, we want to find J, or the radiosity. So let's start by doing an energy balance, and what happens is that En, the rate of heat transfer or energy, is equal to E out. Irradiation comes into both surfaces, and radiosity leaves both surfaces as well. Well, what about convection? Well, if the surface temperature, so if TS is greater than the bulk temperature of the fluid, T infinity, then convection will leave the surface as occurs here. So if we do our energy balance, we come with En, which is our irradiation, is going to be equal to our convective heat transfer, as well as radiosity. Now, if you notice, you have the convection and the radiation from both sides, but dividing everything by two just gives us our basic energy balance. So first, let's find our Q convection. And if you notice, we deal in watts per meter squared. And according to Newton's law of cooling, this is just going to be equal to the heat transfer coefficient times the change in temperature. If you take a look at our values above, this is equal to 50 watts per meter squared Kelvin, 360K minus 310K, and our Q convection is going to be equal to 2,500 watts per meter squared. So next we're going to look at the irradiation. So our irradiation is given as 8,000 watts per meter squared. And this is going to be equal to our 2,500 watts per meter squared, which is Q convection, plus the radiosity. Therefore, we can calculate the radiosity as 5,500 watts per meter squared. So is this plate a black body? Well, if there is an emissivity, then the plate is not a black body. So let's check to see if there is. So J consists of everything that leaves the surface, which is going to be equal to the emissive power, E, plus what's reflected of the radiation off the surface. Since the plate is semi-transparent, we have a reflected, absorbed, and transmitted radiation. So our G is going to be equal to our reflected plus our transmitted plus our alpha absorbed. And you can see from this that rho plus tau plus alpha is going to be equal to 1. So our emissive power is going to be equal to the emissivity. And if the emissivity is less than 1, then we don't have a black body, times sigma, which is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, times the surface temperature raised to the 4th. So if we put this all together, we find that J is equal to epsilon sigma TS to the 4th plus 1 minus alpha times G. And what we did was we rewrote that equation and used this relationship. And now we can solve for our emissivity to see if it is equal to 1. So this is J minus 1 minus alpha times G. And this whole thing is divided by sigma T of the surface to the fourth. And when we put in the numbers, we find that this epsilon is equal to 0.74, which is less than 1. So this means that the plate is not a black body.